afternoon to all of you here present. I must first, of course, Secretary Sri Sanjay Kumasing. This has been a very wonderful experience for myself, and I must express my deepest appreciation for having us, for Singapore, to be part of this very grand event. Now, I would like to first of all mention that our relationship and partnership with OSEA, IT Education Services Singapore, was first conceived 1.5 years ago. And I must say that over the last 1.5 years, it has developed to an extent where I could not recognize where we have begun for the better. And just as any relationship, in particular a love relationship, I must say that we have fallen in love with Odisha. But this is not the end, because in any relationship, you need to have both parties and love each other, right? So what I have decided to do is to introduce my organization to you by showing you a 5-minute video. And I hope...
And Galaxy of the invited guests who have come all the way to deliberate on various aspects on the skill development. I would like to express my hearty welcome to Sri Lim Boon Tiong, Director, ITES, Singapore. We welcome you, Mr. Boon. I would like to welcome
Country Head of ADB, Mr. Boon Tiong from IT Singapore.
Change the entire landscape and the skill ecosystem in Odisha. So therefore, we are saying that we will have a phased approach as far as skill development. Nations of the world will come to Odisha to hire. And one of the beginnings which we have made is collaborating with IT Singapore in achieving this objective in the midterm. Long term. Now, when 2016, we had set up the Odisha Skill Development Authority under the chairmanship of Sri Subrata Bagchi, who is present here. We had set these three strategies for ourselves. First is fix the ITI. Why fix the ITI? Because as I said, the core domain skill comes from ITI. And we believe in OSTA and in government of Odisha that there can be no shortcut.
That their alumni are serving as senior skilled professionals working in different organizations across the globe. And therefore, we first started with this program of identifying the role models. And we said that every ITI has to have 10 role models. Out of the 10 role models, there have to be 6 who have gone out and they are working outside the state.
This is a picture of Tirupur, where most of the women who are working there are from Odisha, and we have set up centers to reach out to our women in Tirupur. Under DDUGKY, in the short-term skilling, we have been declared as the best state in the country for last 2 years consecutively.
We'll send our trainees from here to participate in World Skills competition, and we will get at least 1 gold medal for India, 2 silver medals for India, and 3 bronze medals for India. And this mission we started in January of this year.
I think the state of Odisha deserves a very big round of applause for that. And ma'am, congratulations for making Odisha, which is extremely, I think, wonderful conclave. FICCI did a report on future of jobs in 2016. In which it was identified that there are 3 primary forces that will impact the skill development in the country, and that is globalization, the demographic changes, and industry adoption of industry 4.0 technologies. In the backdrop of what Secretary has just shared, Orissa also has a challenge of about a skill gap, a demand supply gap of 4 million people by 2026. And it plans to skill about 1.4. What are the short term, mid term, and long term aims of OSDA and the government of Orissa? In this backdrop, we have a esteemed panel of speakers who are going to share what they have been doing so far and what kind of innovations that can be brought in the skill development arena, which can be adopted by the government of Orissa. So to begin with, I will invite Mr. Lim Boom Tiong, Director ITEES, to give his presentation. He's going to show us a video followed by a speech. When we are talking about 21st century skill sets, it's not just about technology, it is the very way of life that is going to be changing. And that infusion of technology and the new way of life is actually going to be the paradigm shift that we will be seeing. May I now request Ms. Rinjin Nam, Head Talent Acquisition, Suzuki Motors, to share our views.
First of all, good afternoon everyone here. And I would definitely go by Mr. Rajiv that definitely something which all of us, I'm sure all the panelists here, must have their
general skill, steel to make his presentation or
thank you, Shobha. And a very good afternoon to all of you, most beautiful ladies and gentlemen. After having heard and gone through the presentation that Sanjay ji made, I actually changed the context of what I have to speak today. Because I came here with a kind of a mind. Ultimately, what's the context of skilling today? The context of skilling today is very important because as people have been saying that this is the fourth industrial revolution in midst of which we are working around Industry 4.0. And therefore, the skills have to necessarily be dovetailed with this need of the hour, which is a future. But strangely enough, we are talking about a future that has already arrived. And from the context springs the approach and the vision and the values that you've created. That's very well aligned to the fact that ultimately fourth industrial revolution is not about, as the earlier three were, with span of time, with change of time, hundreds or 150 years passing in between, from steam to electricity, electricity to telecom. It's all about convergence of the cyberspace, the physical space, and the biospace. So therefore, when we are talking about skilling in the context of the fourth industrial revolution, you see those days, and I could be the probably the first one there. We selected 400 people from ITIs and then we gave them ITI trainings. And these 400 people were then, through SP College of, SP Jain College of Mumbai, were given training to become diploma engineers within the next 10-12 years. And most of them, I would say, and I recently checked up with the chairman when we had a meeting, that almost 118 out of these 400 are now BS in Power Engineering from BITS Pilani. And that's Orissa for you, ladies and gentlemen. And these were those 400 villagers in and around Kenya village who have made it to BSN Power Engineering. So therefore, when we talk of skills in ITI, we are now talking of a very different order, where paradigm shift, and I'm very happy to see design thinking being a part of it. Because what is design thinking ultimately? Design thinking is a new way of looking at the world altogether. We have been living it linearly. But once in 2007, the Facebook had occurred, the Twitter had arrived, the iPhone had arrived. It means you had a business performance platform, which makes even the SAP, JD Edwards,
the right kind of attitudes to be built in the people and the value system. So there will be four paradigms of skilling: the knowledge domain, the skill basic per se, the kind of, you know, attitudes right that have to be built around that, and the value system. So therefore, if we build an agile competence in these people, they'll be with aspirations, I think, they'll be delivering what we need as a nation building, you know, requirement of today. Those ugly prognostications will not hold good, because the future that's going to come, they'll be, is basically of the mind, heart, body and soul. It's redefining the very algorithm of our life. So therefore, I think with this infusion and this high order visioning of by the Orissa state, I think is going to take a long way, and it's actually removing the difference between manufacturing.
Some technical issues around that, but we have to move from a mindset of salary to that of, you know, your capability, your capability, competence to earn more. What happens is that this technology would be the grand leveler. So a person who is actually aligned with the blue collar job and that level of working, if he or she upgrades and we are able to do that within fusion of technology, take it to a level, this differentiation, as I said, will then become domain specific or domain agnostic beyond blue knowledge and the right value system and attitude to work. So that is what makes a man complete and competent. So competence is basically designed and defined as knowledge, skill and attitude plus the value sets that are required. So if they're thinking of the future, that's where this differentiation between blue and white collar will go away. Because see, even today, a simple thing like welding, if a welder of a level 5 or next level with using technology to the hilt and making yourself more and more, you know, what is called cobotics rather than robotics. Cobotics is when people start collaborating, co-creating, human beings work with robots. So you welcome the technology, embrace that technology, you enter in the world of cobotics from merely robotics. So that's where technical and behavioral skills will take you to a higher level, combined together. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Just to share a few numbers, because we are partnering with a lot of hiring and making my job extremely easier, because I talk about my number is like 18,000, the kind of number that we're targeting to hire in next 1 year. And a major issue that we face is that 50% people do not even qualify. And just to give you a live example, that we have recently done a drive in the month of June in Odisha, where we have almost got 2,800 ITI students, and out of that, more than 70% qualified. Again, repeating copy paste to other states, that's a request. So that's more to do with what I can say. We will be doing a lot of tomorrow itself. We're doing another drive, because the numbers were so good and we intend to do multiple drives and intend to focus the kind of numbers that I have just shared to get as much as from Odisha. So thank you so much. Thank you.
For developing Odisha as a skill manpower hub, for not only for the country but for the entire world, and Vision clearly states that. I would like to give you a little perspective about automotive industry which I belong to. When we are talking about manufacturing, because we are talking about skill development in manufacturing area, automobile in India contributes close to 20% to our GDP. So it's one of the largest employer in terms of an industry. Large number of skilled manpower is required, and this is one area. And in the long term means 10 to 12 years of time, we are planning to produce and sell not less than 5 million cars. Now this 2 million sales happens with great work done by our more than 2 lakh skilled manpower who are associated with our value chain in different level, be it manufacturing, logistics, dealer partners, vendor partners, or our value-added services. Now think of a scenario, in just about 10 to 12 years of time, this industry is expecting a 3-fold growth. Indian car in automotive industry, which is currently
make in Odisha event to attract investors, I think this is a very necessary step to bring industry captains, industrialization in this state. And I must say that skills and the industry must talk. People who are involved in skills development and people in the industry, they must talk. There should not be an absence of communication. In fact, that communication must be ongoing, proactive, and continuous. And I think if you go along that direction, you will never go very far up. You will never go wrong. And you will not have a situation where you've got to decide whether it is skill relevant or not, because you have a purpose in mind. And one of that purpose is to really meet the needs of the industry. So today, if you are bringing in high technology into Odisha, what are the institutions going to do? You've got to prepare in advance. But if you do not know what is happening in the industry, then you have
Mr. Secretary, Mr. Dr. and Mr. Singh, taking your case of advice, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Asian Development Bank, please let me pass to express my sincere gratitude to be able to have been established in this country.
As introduced by Mr. Singh,
everything is presently starting a partnership with the OSPA. We highly appreciate this partnership opportunity, providing $85 million of loan assistance plus $2 million of technical assistance grant to operationalize the sector skills. And this was identified based on the thorough state level economic development planning process and industrial development plan, and also our assisted industrial development strategy. For the service sector, we all know that very high potentials have been identified for infrastructure risks that will prepare skill acquirers to work for modern smart cities and high-rise buildings. To advance courses related to tourism sector, covering beauty and wellness, and hair, fashion, and design that are also introduced. And one related to logistics services. My favorite minister in the state, who is leading a very successful project, who says, if one aims at a tree, you can go only as high as a tree. Rather, you should aim at the going to the moon, so that you can go way above the trees.
Thank you very much, sir. The Honorable Chairman, OSDA, Honorable Principal Secretary, and distinguished delegates on and off the states. So I'm delighted to be in the skill capital of India, Orissa, undoubtedly. So I want to structure my 10 minutes talk into four parts. One, I want to talk about the industry briefly, then shortages in the industry, the challenges which led to innovations and the best practices, because skill is a very nascent industry. So in the last few years, whatever challenges we have faced, innovations and the best practices. Then what is unique about Odisha out of our experience? So when it comes to, it is not a norm to speak an Indian shortage. With World Skill Center coming up, I think we should talk about the global skill shortages in healthcare. So the challenges that we have seen over the course of last 3 years and what innovations we have built. So if I put the skill lifecycle into mobilization, training, placement, post-placement. So in mobilization, definitely the aspiration lodging was a big challenge which led to dropouts, not just for us, but I think across the industry. So there are many tools that were developed, but we are successfully using a tool called Aspiration Lodger now, which is actually taken from the industry knowledge. We have jointly built it with Microsoft. We actually do an Aspiration Lodge of every student who will be taking through a level one screening, which is a kind of a pictorial screening. Students will get an opportunity to flip through images of multiple trades. They flip through
how to keep adequate warm, how to assist mother during the breastfeeding time. So we built this module and we have trained over 1,000 people and placed them in leading home health companies like Cornea Nightingales across India. This is some of the curriculum innovations that we have made. Then simulation integrated learning, this is becoming very, very critical, especially in the allied health sector, because when we are actually training on a scale, we cannot give an on-job training or an internship on such a large scale in the hospitals. Today, so simulation becomes very important. I'll just give an example of phlebotomy technicians who will come home and collect samples.
The corporate, we are very afraid of working with the government because the government means paperwork, the government means delays, and which is why a lot of corporates will say, okay, fine, we'll come and hire from you, but we don't necessarily want to train for you. We don't want to be a part of your programs because we don't have those kind of resources and mind space. But Orissa is one of the first states which said, you know, we will figure out the paperwork environment. So I think they're not just, you know, the branding that we see and the made in to take one of these containers and create those into classrooms. And this is the first mobile skill container that we created. These are air conditioned, they can be moved anywhere. So and that's what it looks like, is, you know, that's our first skilling. We work with the bank, so we take on the risk of paying off the loan, which we pay on every month. So their EMI is paid every time they work for us, they do a delivery. We have created over 1,000 logistic entrepreneurs in the past 3 years. They earn anything from 40 to 50,000 rupees, and they have manpower they employ of over 10 to 15 people. So I think partnering with industry for nano unicorns, if we can get industry on board to offer permanent opportunities to our unicorns, will definitely help us scale this forward and provide local self-employment opportunities. In want to start earning right away. So Socho is an idea that can we have a technology platform where they skill themselves post and while they're working. So it's a personal, it's sort of like Netflix, where you can actually choose your training and it's based on business outcomes.
For a bhashan after 3 o'clock, so I will make it short. If you're wondering why I'm being invited here to talk to this gathering, probably I think I will make an educated guess. It is because I being the mentor and the coach for the only silver medal that team. My understanding is that you guys can hear what I'm talking because there is no any backup speaker here. So yeah. The first and the foremost is when the World Skills was introduced, none of the states knew what World Skills were. The World Skills started in the year 1945, and India became a partner of the World Skills only in the year 2012.
I think I'm going to discuss something, you know, additional to what has already been talked about. So as an organization, I'll share a few secrets. So I'm from Vivo Healthcare. The good news or the bad news is nobody in the senior leadership is a doctor. While our core business is saving lives, and that is our motivation, that we save lives. So the good news is we know what we don't know, right? And our objective is to fix a problem. And that is how we look at skilling, and our core focus is we believe there's an opportunity. We train basic life support, advanced cardiac life support programs. So we train from security guards, school drivers, school children to doctors on what to do when somebody collapses. So how do you even recognize a medical emergency? So the intention is the community needs to know. Most of us probably have experienced subah bathroom gaye, collapse kar gaye. Now what are we supposed to do at that point in time? How many of our cars parked outside are not going to help? Somebody needs to know what to do, which kind of hospital to go to. There are two things. Now, if you go to a hospital, it's like a shopping mall. The first thing is, do I really reach the hospital?
I can proudly say, 8 years ago, when I said our students will work in the US, people laughed at me. But with pride, I can say our students today are working in the US embassy in India. So, I mean, you know, so we're saying India mein USA pahunch gaye. So, at least, you know, so we are at ground that skill. And the biggest thing is the self-confidence. The person has to be able to deal at the international level. So, one is, not only the skill of that individual for that trade, but also the social skill and the self-confidence that the person needs in healthcare. Having said all this, there are a few challenges. The biggest one, and there are areas where we need support. Now, my guesstimate, I might be wrong, is about 60% of the people working in hospitals are not certified. Just the first level, if we can get legislation, we can get something, shouldn't that person be certified? It will ensure some level of quality. If you are able to enforce this and save and educating them to the base level, setting the right expectations can change a lot. The government's initiative in the recent past are tremendous. I think it's going to have a huge impact on health skills, the need for health skills, Ayushman Bharat, and all the other related programs. And what we are really excited about healthcare, it's a no-brainer. But what we are more excited about, simple paramedics can solve these problems. Look at it another way, there is a huge opportunity. In fact, the most disruptive technology going forward will come in healthcare. So computing, information technology. technology, healthcare are all going to integrate into bioinformatics, which, I mean, most people don't even understand what it can do.
He does not himself have the competence to check blood pressure. I mean, it's not a very complicated piece of equipment to use, but that is how they do. They end up going visiting a doctor, and doctors are in short supply. So paramedics, I mean, I just tell you an opportunity that is they came to Vivo Healthcare and hired paramedics. So three of our girls from Lucknow became superstars because they're the only girls now working for Indigo Airlines. I just want to talk about an example. In India, when we talk home healthcare, you know, we are training lots of DDAs and then they go and help in hospitals. But when you work, how it works in the US is, a nurse who's worked all her life now wants to take it easy. So she goes into home healthcare, right? Now, so she has lots of other experience in our hospital doing nothing. Now, if they were to imbibe these skills, now their skills is to help other elderly people. So there is a lot of opportunity for us to integrate, think laterally, and I think I'm in the right place, and that's why I've been smiling all day today after hearing, you know, all of them talk about, you know, what all is possible in Orissa, and I think, and I look forward to being a part of the journey. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I would now request Mr. D.K. Singh to kindly
Seriously, I will tell that we have taken ourselves and our work very seriously. But we are not giving anybody chance. Odisha is continuously performing, and let me tell you perspective. The target for Odisha is 1.76 lakhs. And the target for, we have the second highest target in the country. And which state has the highest, place the highest number of people? As the Secretary Skill Development was telling, our IITs, ITIs, our ITIs are now recognized.
Crossroad by a hangman, a nurse giving an injection. So students are expected to select 30 images randomly. And out of those 30 images that they select, we actually gauge their aspiration.
Think investment. Think Odisha.